Resistors can be combined in two ways. You can either combine them in series or in parallel. That's resistor 2. That's resistor 3. Current is flowing through. So one thing about resistors in series is that they will always have the same current going through them. But much as they're having the same current going through them, the potential drops across the respective resistors are going to be different. Same current going through them, but different potential drops. So it only means that the voltage across resistor 1 will be V1. The resistance across the potential drop across resistor 2 is V2. And the potential drop across resistor 3 is V3. And then they'll have the same current I going through. Since they have different potential drops across them, it means that for us to get the total voltage or the total potential drop between this point and that point will mean that it is going to be V1 plus V2 plus V3 to get the potential difference between this end and that end. So in essence here, the total voltage V here is going to be equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3, like that. Now, what is the formula for voltage? Remember, in our previous video, we came up with this conclusion that voltage is equal to IR. We got this from Ohm's law. So if V is equal to IR, it means that here, the total current going through the whole thing, which is capital I, times the effective resistance of all these three resistors, which we shall call capital R, is going to be equal to voltage across this resistor, which is the current going through this resistor, which is I, which is the same as that, times that resistor R1 plus capital I, because it's the same current going through I, times the resistor R2 plus V3, which is equal to the same current going through, which is I, times R3. So if we factorize out I here, we remain with I into R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is equal to capital I and capital R. Then we find that this I and that I will cancel out. We remain with capital R. The effective resistance of those resistors in series will be equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. And this becomes our formula for finding any resistors that are in series, whether they are 3 or 4 or 5. You simply add up all their resistances. So this is for resistors in series. Let's look at resistors in parallel. We have a resistor there. We have a resistor there. We have a resistor there. This is R1, R2, resistor 3. So we have current coming in here, let's call it I0, and we have current going out here, it is the same current I0. So current comes in here. When it comes, it gets divided. Some current goes here, some current goes here, some current goes here. It goes through these resistors, and when it comes back here, it recombines at that joint and it comes out as I0. So the kind of current or the amount of current that is going through resistor 1 can't be the same as the current that is coming in here, because when it reaches that junction, it splits up. So it means that as current is coming in, some of it is going up here as I1, some is going through here, let's call that I2, and some of it here is going down as I3. And so when these respective currents go, when they meet at this junction, this I3 and that I2 and this I1 will recombine and will formulate back the original current that came in. So what does that tell us? It tells us that this current I0 is going to be equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Still, from our formula, V is equal to IR, if we're making I the subject of the formula, I is going to be equal to V over R. But there's some fundamental thing that you need to know about resistors that are arranged in parallel. Remember, we said before that for resistors that are arranged in series, there are different potential drops across every resistor. The potential drop here, or the PD across this resistor, is different from the PD across this resistor, and it's different from the PD across this resistor. And if we want to find the potential difference across all these three, it means that we are going to add all them. That is what we did here. That is for resistors that are in series. But when we come to resistors that are in parallel, it is the same potential difference across all these three. That is the difference between this and that. The potential difference across resistors that are in parallel is the same. So it means that for big current, I is equal to V over R. So it means that capital V, because it's the same potential difference across, over the effective resistance of these three, which we shall call capital R, is going to be equal to the current going through I1, the current I1, which is going through resistor 1. So it's going to be capital V, which is the small, it's the same PD across, divide that by R1. That's going to be plus I2, current going through I2 is going to be the potential difference V, which is the same capital V over R2 plus V over R3. So this means it's going to bring V over R is going to be equal to V outside the brackets into 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. We just prime factorized out the V. So we find that this V and that V cancel out to remain with 1 over R is going to be equal to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 1 over R3. And this is the general formula for finding the effective resistance of resistors that are in parallel. So this is a formula we use. And for series, we just add. For those that are in parallel, this is what we use. For example, if they told us that 2 ohms, 4 ohms, and 5 ohms are in parallel, find their effective resistance. The effective resistance would be 1.05 ohms. You can go ahead and calculate that using this formula and you'll get the answer. In our next video, we shall be looking at more examples where we shall be using some of these formulas. This brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like and share this video, and for more videos, please subscribe. Please like our Facebook page at Kisembo Academy Video Tutorials, or follow us on Twitter at Kisembo Academy. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Rangakuramia. Catch you in the next video.